I was still trying to figure out what's a winding chain. Missionary Baptist went in, didn't we? Amen. I'm like, y'all, we need some words on the teleprompter next time meet you, but we all can join in together. Because I didn't know that one. I was trying to go follow with it, you know. Hey, I was looking for somebody to feed me the words. Every now and then I got one in. Amen. Amen. It's just good to be here today. Amen. Amen. Let's give God a hand praise. Amen. I will not be before you long. This will be more of a devotional message. Amen. Amen. You can have your seats. Amen. Amen. Now, y'all want to sing Amazing Grace? All right, Hill. Praises go up, blessings come down. Amen. Praise God with your whole heart. With your whole heart. Praise. Praise. Praise God. Praise God. Heavenly Father, we just come before your throne of grace this morning, Lord. I ask that you will empty me out and pour more into me. Whatever you want me to say, whatever you want me to do, oh God, I'm an empty vessel. Use me, Lord, and it's a humbling experience, oh God, to just be used as a vessel unto you. I'm just an oracle in Jesus' name. I give you the glory to prepare the hearts of your people to receive a word, to hear a word, unstop the ears this morning. In Jesus' name, I give you glory. Amen. Amen. We're going to be coming from 1 Timothy chapter 3, verse 15. 1 Timothy chapter 3, verse 15. In the King James Version reads, "But if I tarry long, that thou mayest know how thou oughtest behave," how you act, "thyself in the house of God, which is the church of the living God, the pillow and ground of the truth." Amen. "But if I tarry long, that thou mayest know how thou oughtest to behave thyself in the house of God, which is the church of the living God, the pillar and ground of the truth." Amen. For a little while, I'm going to be talking about seven things about thyself. Say it with me. Seven things. Seven things. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven things about thyself. We have to look at ourselves, how we ought to act. The first scripture, 1 Timothy 3 and 15, how we ought to act in the house of God. Okay? Behave, number one, behave thyself. Number two, I'm going to go back. I'm just giving it to you right now. Number two, exercise thyself. Three, give thyself. Four, take heed to thyself. Five, save thyself. Six, keep thyself. And seven, withdraw thyself. Number one, behave thyself. We need to know how to behave ourselves in the house of God. You know, we have commercialized this thing for way too long. We allow any and everything go on in the house of God. That is not how it was in the early church, in the first church. We need to know how to learn how to conduct ourselves in the house of God. God's house is not our own house, so we shouldn't come in here acting the way we act at home. We should give reverence into this house. This is the living room of God. When you come into the house of God, you should feel a reverence, an awe, and it's splendid. But we come in, the business of the day, carrying on just like we at home. We talk just like we at home. Sometimes we laugh and chitter-chatter just like we at home. We be on our cell phone just like we at home. But there's a way we need to come. The word of God tells us to enter into his gates. And I say this all the time. Enter to his gates. That's the parking lot. Enter his gates with thanksgiving. Enter his courts with praise. That's how you should behave in the house of God. We have all the time to do whatever we want. He's granted us plenty of time to do whatever we want to do. But when we come into this house, it should be a difference. We should be ready to praise him. We should be ready to worship him. We should be ready to give him thanks. We should be ready to give, render our all unto him, into his house. 1 Corinthians 6 and 12. All things are lawful unto me, but all things are not expedient. There are things I can do in my own house that I dare not do in this house. You know, we say some little ugly stuff in here, but you know, we see coding going on in this house. We talk that slang talk in this house. I remember way back when, them ushers, we couldn't get up. Babies be walking all across. I had to get on kids. I said, stop letting Parker walk all across this church. I'm just, y'all, did that not happen? Am I the only one went? Okay. But we have gotten so far away from the early church, the way God has called the church to be. We've gotten too comfortable. It's time for us to come back. Say, come back, come back, come back, come back, come back. Come back. Joshua 24 and 15, Joshua said, as everybody know this, as for what? As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. Is that what's going on in your house? Woo. Be real. Be true. Be set free. That's right. Because we don't. I remember growing up, if mama didn't go to church, we went to church. They sent us to church. As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. We didn't want to go, but it was good for us because the word of God tells us to train up a child the way he should go. That's why I always look at these little babies, punch these little babies right here. This baby was in your womb. Probably wasn't even in your womb then. Look at Addison. I remember Addison one day. I said, look at it. I was caught up one day. Then I just so happened to open my eyes, and she was caught up. And I'm like, dog, I got me out the spirit looking at her. Because, you know, out of the mouth of babes, because they praising him, because they see what's going on in the house. They see what's going on in the house. Br- bring your children. Let them see the light of Christ in you at home, not just at church, but at home. Amen. Aaron, that's right, preacher. Send them a dollar. Teach them how to give when it's time to give. Don't teach them how to give. Aaron's son, Numbers 3 and 4, and 26 and 21. Let's go there. Numbers, that's in the Old Testament. Chapter 3. And I'm just still on what? Behave thyself. You're still on the first. Behave thyself. Numbers 3, verse 4. And Nadab and Abihu died before the Lord when they offered strange fire before the Lord. And y'all hear us all the time saying we will not offer this strange smoke. We just coming in here doing out of routine. God is not pleased with it. He is not pleased with us just coming in. Okay, we got to order serve right here. We got to do it right here. Okay, it's hot in here. We got to hurry. God is not pleased with it. That's strange smoke. He is not receiving it. Because they that worship him must worship him and in truth. Yes, it's hot outside. I mean, hot in here. It's warm in here, but it's not unbearable. You got the fan. Amen? Strange smoke, just doing anything up in God's house. Because we don't have music, you can't clap your hands. Because you hot, you rather fan than clap. Strange smoke. Aaron's son offered strange fire in God's house, and he paid for it with their lives. They paid for it with their what? Offering this strange smoke. We better check ourselves when we come into God's house. And Nadab and Abihu died before the Lord when they, that's what it says. That's the first. Y'all see it? When they offer strange fire before the Lord in the wilderness of Sinai. And they had no children. And Eleazar, what's the next word? Ithamar, minister in the priest's office in the sight of Aaron, their father. Because, you know, sometimes when we be in the wilderness, those wilderness days, those wilderness experiences, when you low, when you depressed, when you down, now when you stressed, then you come in here and you still the same way. Because they were in the wilderness, but they died there. Because they offered up their strange smoke, they're grumbling and they're complaining in God's house. And he already told us what to do. Bring your burdens to the altar. Lay them there at the altar. It's simple. Just leave them there. Now, I'm not saying, because we all go through. We all have issues, okay? But in this house, that's where you need to be free and just listen to the word of the Lord and just receive it so you can be free, so you can be delivered. Amen? 2, exercise thyself. Exercise thyself. 1 Timothy 4 and 7. 1 Timothy 4 and 7, exercise thyself. And I'm talking about 7 things about thyself. We need to check ourselves. Amen? 1 Timothy 4 and 7. But refuse profane and old wives' fables, and exercise thyself rather unto godliness. And I'm going to read that out of the Message translation. Exercise daily in God. No spiritual flabbiness, please. Workouts in the gymnasium are useful, but a disciplined life in God is far more so, making you fit both today and forever. You can count on this. You can count on it. So we need to start exercising our godliness, praying more, worshiping, and not just in here, but at home. Amen? Exercise yourself. We must train ourselves not to react, but to always respond. We must exercise our senses so we can discern both good and both evil. See, that's how you exercise yourself. When you get in the Word of God, you'll be able to discern what's good, what is of God, and what is not. But you got to exercise. You got to do something. You got to stay in that Word. Because folk can tell you anything, you'll take it with the wind and go on. Amen? We must be able to judge what's good and what's God. That's how you exercise yourself. The devil will always tempt God's people with good. What seems good. What we think is good. That must have been a blessing, Lord. I went to Walmart and guess what? She didn't even check my ribs out, my slab of ribs out. Ain't God good? But how many of us have said that before? I'm sorry, Tan work at Walmart. We ain't do Tan. We ain't go to her register one shop. Yeah. We do it all the time. The devil will always tempt God's people what's good. However, good has one good. How do you spell good? Huh? Okay, I just want to know. Y'all went to spelling. However, good has one too many O's in it. Everything good is not God. But everything God is good. Amen? Everything good is not God, but everything God is good. We must exercise or train ourselves to move by faith and not our feelings. Okay? I was studying last night. Well, I haven't been asleep. I've been up over 24 hours, literally. I mean, literally. Like, what? I didn't know if I was going to make it down here this morning because I was like, fail myself, weaving. Anyway. But when I was studying last night, this wasn't the word, it was another word. I was looking at Lot. And Lot, he walked by sight. You know, Lot, who, Abraham, nephew, y'all remember, y'all know him. Abraham was a man of faith, right? He didn't walk by sight. God told him to go and he went. He didn't see it, but he went. Lot, he looked over there and see, okay, I'm going over there, over yonder. That was before God destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah. But he saw all that was good. Because see, that's the thing. People who don't have faith, they always look at things like it's good. They look at things with their eyes like it's good. It's perception. It's good. I'm going to get that. But you have to, the righteous must what? Live by faith. 1 Timothy, give thyself. Say, give thyself. Give thyself. Give thyself. Thank you. Yeah, I had to chilling on it. Give thyself. 1 Timothy 4 and 15. I'm just giving you 7 principles about thyself. Give thyself. 1 Timothy 4 and 15. Lord Jesus. Meditate upon these things. Give thyself wholly to them, that thy profiting may appear to all. Amen. 1 Thessalonians, I'm just giving you scriptures about give that. Got this skirt on. 1 Thessalonians 5 and 23. 1 Thessalonians, we're using the word today. I hope y'all writing these scriptures down so y'all can go back and check them out. 1 Thessalonians 5 and 23. And the very God of peace sanctify you wholly. And I pray, God, your whole spirit and soul and body be preserved blameless unto the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. We give ourselves to God through our what? Sister Joe just talked about it. Our time, our talents, our gifts, our possessions, and whatever we can render unto the Lord, that's how we give thyself. Why are we so stingy when it comes to God's house? when it's time to give. We open that cafe back there. I'm like, we can't hardly make change because there'd be so many 20s up in there. But then we get ready to do pass the buck. We only have enough bucks on our roll. Because what, you're not getting anything personally back? What is it? But God, he gives everything. He gave us everything. Give thyself. Romans 12 and 1, I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that ye present your bodies a living sacrifice. What? I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that ye present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. The least you can do. Amen? Give thyself. Take heed to thyself. Okay? That's principle 4. We only have 3 more left. Take heed to thyself. 1 Timothy 4 and 16. We're still staying in 1 Timothy. Okay? So y'all might want to go back and read 1 Timothy 4 and 16. Again, take heed to thyself. We must watch ourselves. Because self is always trying to get out of control. This flesh is something, ain't it? It's, you know, we don't even have to practice to do wrong. We trying to potty train Park, okay? I told Kelsey, sit her little tail on that pot, because she can, if she can talk, ooh, I got it, she can get on the pot. Okay? So she sit there, I say, sit her there. So she just sit there. Kelsey say she sat there about 35, 40 minutes. Just reading to old Toodles. Just reading all it. Kelsey say she got up. She went in the back, did something. All of a sudden, Parker got up. She was in the living room. He went in there and got a towel out of her drawer. She know where her towels are. Wiping the floor. She done got up off the pot and trying to wipe it up before her mama come. So kids already know. You don't, they don't have to be taught to do wrong. This flesh gets out of control. You don't have to be taught to do wrong. But it's hard to do right. You got to strive to do right. You got to encourage yourself to do right. We must watch what we believe because what we believe determines how we behave. Our actions result from our beliefs. Our belief results from our thinking. Our thinking results from our knowledge. And our knowledge results from our source. And there is only 2 sources, God and the devil. You love one and hate the other. You cannot serve 2. You cannot straddle the fence. God said it makes him sick. He'd rather you be hot or cold, not lukewarm. Matthew 16 and 23, Peter was rebuked by Jesus because he failed to watch himself. David sinned with Bathsheba because he failed to watch himself. If we fail to watch ourselves, we can come under the influence of the wrong spirit. And we talking about these them spirits in Bible and wow, demonology, spiritual warfare, binding and loosing. Failure to watch yourself can result in prayerlessness. Prayerlessness. Which is, if you don't pray, there's a sin. 5th one, save thyself. We're still 1 Timothy 16. Save thyself. Matthew 16, verses 24 and 25. Let's go to Matthew 16, verses 24 and 25. I can't see that up there. Then said Jesus unto his disciples, if any man will come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. For whosoever will save his life shall lose it. And whosoever shall lose his life for my sake shall find it. Amen? We all must deny ourselves from something or we'll be caught up in every single thing. We also have to save ourselves through our spiritual talk. And this ushers in preaching, speaking the good news concerning the Son of God. See, that's how we watch ourselves through our spiritual talk. I mean, I'm not saying every time you go around, praise God, hallelujah, God is good, amen, da 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 da. But we should be using the kingdom language instead of this slang language whenever we can. You know, speak those things that be not as though they were. You may not have any money in your pocket. You may not, but you can. God owns all the cattle of 1,000 hills. Amen? Amen. Through our spiritual talk, we can save others for Christ. Through a burden to save others, we will save ourselves. Amen? Keep thyself. Say, keep thyself. This is the sixth principle. 1 Timothy 5:22. 1 Timothy 5:22. Keep thyself. Lay hands suddenly on no man. Neither be partaker of another man's sins. Of other men's sins. Keep thyself pure. We must keep ourselves pure and not allow another to pollute our minds or motives. It's easy to get caught up in some listening to the wrong stuff. We keep ourselves pure by not submitting, by not substituting God for gain. Don't look for glamour, seek for glory. Don't look for what's hip, seek what's holy. We must look for the supernatural, not something spectacular. We must desire God's power and not man's personality or performance. And we know there's a lot of performing going on in God's church. It's too much. Come in here and preach the word of God, receive the word of God, and go home. But it's too much performance going on in God's house. Amen? The last one is withdraw thyself. Withdraw thyself. 1 Timothy 6:5. I'm going to be hoarse tomorrow. No, I'm not. In the name of Jesus. What I just said, speak. See, thank you. And that's what we need, the kingdom language. Ask the Holy Spirit to come on and convict you, because he is our helper. He is our friend. Amen. I'm just saying, I'm a hurry, y'all. Amen. Withdraw thyself. 1 Timothy 6:5. Perverse disputings of men of corrupt minds and destitute of the truth, supposing that gain is godliness, from such withdraw yourself, thyself. You ain't got to listen to that mess. My contact probably about to blow off out of my eye. You don't have to listen to that corrupt and that filthy lucre. Amen? We need to keep ourselves pure by withdrawing ourselves from certain unruly company. 1 Corinthians 15:33 says, be not deceived. Evil communication, corrupt good manners. We must withdraw ourselves from those who render false flattery. Some flatter you with the intent to do you harm. Because especially women, you know, some women are so easily flattered. Don't know game when they see it, when they hear it. So they'll be caught up and they just being deceived by the men so the man can get what they want. I don't know. I'm not easily flattered, but I'm just saying some are. But we need to ask God to show us that we can recognize when we're being, trying to be, you know, pulled into that chatter. Amen? Amen. Now, the seven principles are, we in WOW, it's okay. All right. Okay. Amen. Those are the seven principles to check thyself. Amen. So check yourself before you wreck yourself. Amen. To God be all of the glory. Amen.